Hi guys, welcome back. Today we're going to take a closer look at Klaus. This is the third book in the series and it's the life and times of Santa Claus. It says on the back here, Klaus must help an absentee dad turned snowman make amends before melting away for good. And then see Klaus in a role of father himself as he takes in Joe Christmas as an infant and guides him through a life's wild adventures in a holiday calendar inspired comic. Collects Klaus and the Crying Snowman 1, Klaus and the Life and Times of Joe Christmas 1. So let's take a closer look at the book itself and then we can come back and discuss my thoughts. As with the other volumes of Klaus, this is a really well-built book overall. We've got Grant Morrison, Dan Mora on the front here, Klaus with our image to do with the story in this particular book. It says The Life and Times of Santa Claus. We've got Klaus, The Life and Times of Santa Claus and our creators gilded sort of down the side here with another symbol at the bottom. And then we've got the sort of synopsis of the book. Various kind of quotes and awards kind of won by Dan Mora. I love Dan Mora's art, so it's really cool to see. And then we've got Klaus here with, I believe it's baby Santa Claus. The edge of the book is gilded, as with the other one, so this is a gold sort of gilding around the entire edge of the book. And the book is a sewn bind and oversized, so it lies out really well and flat. And the spreads have next to no gutter loss, which is really nice to see. So as I say, this is written by Grant Morrison, drawn by Dan Mora, both internal and, you know, all the sort of little extra bits on the cover and things, and then lettered by Ed Jukeshire. The art, as always, is just great in these books, and they lie open really well. I just have no issues at all, really, and they look awesome, they read awesome. I would buy them probably for the art alone, never mind the story. Speaking of which, the second half of the book is actually a sort of Christmas sort of advent calendar, and it takes us through the life of Santa Claus, which is one of the other kind of Claus family members. So we basically just got these different moments, and a lot of them are parodies of, you know, other big movies or shows or stuff. So obviously we've got the DeLorean here from Back to the Future. And then at the back here, we've got some various cover art. Some design work, and our creators. These books are just really, really well built. I don't think I mentioned it that part, but actually on the front of the book you've got gilding outside the kind of Klaus lettering. I don't know how well you guys will see it here, but on the actual picture in the middle you've got gilding on different parts, like their belt buckles and different stuff like that as well. And it's just an awesome attention to detail as far as the build of the book itself is concerned. Other than that, this story was maybe just a little bit more convoluted than the sort of first two volumes. We've got a story about a sort of snowman who is a bit of a bad dad, and he goes on this sort of journey with Klaus and eventually kind of works his way back to his family, I guess, as a kind of Christmas story. And then we've got a further issue, which, as it said on the back, is a sort of advent calendar, and it's just kind of counting down life of Joe Christmas as he kind of becomes Santa Claus, which you'll learn a bit more about him in the first issue as well. So it's quite a fun book. I would have liked a little bit more story in there, as much as I enjoy Dan Mora's art, and I would have bought it as an art book regardless. Second issue basically more or less just being pictures. Didn't really give me as much time to the book as I maybe put into the first couple of volumes. And considering these only really come out one issue a sort of year, and we only get hardcover every sort of other year, it's a little bit disappointing to not have a full kind of issue with, you know, text and everything in that kind of second issue. But I did enjoy it overall. I'd highly recommend checking it out if you did enjoy the first two volumes. I don't think it's something to jump on if you haven't read the first two volumes, because you're going to be just a little bit lost as to what's kind of going on and maybe not quite get quite so much out of it. But it is a really, as I say, fun book for those who have been reading the series overall. Alright guys, let me know below if you've been reading the series so far and if you know, really enjoyed the sort of calendar issue. I kind of personally think it would be nicer to just have a calendar, but you know, it is what it is. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.